Hello, welcome at the Victron Energy Tech Talk. Here we will try to answer as many questions as possible that you have on our products. If you have any questions on your own, please leave them here in the comments bar and we'll try to answer them in the next episode. The first question is coming from Jonathan. Jonathan is asking, I have a Victron battery monitor and if one of my batteries hits the discharge floor, 50% in my case, what does it do? Is it able to disconnect the battery or to protect it? Well, Jonathan, the maximum discharge floor setting has actually two functions. The first one is to have the 0 to 100% icon correct, so that if the discharge floor is 50%, at 50% your icon is at zero. And the other one is to trigger an alarm, so you can connect it to a beeper or a horn or whatever, so you know that you come to the critical point of your battery. The next question is coming from Thomas. Thomas has a Venus device and that Venus device is showing some strange DC values. The solar production is 185 watts, the battery is charging with 131, so in my opinion the DC system should show 45 watts, but it's showing 123. Why is that? Well, Thomas, the reason for that is that the DC load is not actually a measured value. It's calculated from the incoming power from the grid and also the load from your inverter, and it being compared to the power that's going to the battery. So in that calculations, sometimes there is some inaccuracy, and that's why it doesn't add up exactly. The calculation is done as pretty as possible, but you can see every now and then there is some deviation between that. The next one is coming from Alan, and Alan doesn't actually have a question, but he has a remark, and it says, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, the new dashboard is there, lovely, even marching and remotely. Thank you so much, thank you, thank you, thank you. Well, Alan, thank you very much for the compliment, and of course, we also like the new dashboard a lot, so keep it up. The next question is coming from Jan. Jan is asking, I have two 12-volt panels, solar panels. What happens if I serial connect them, or what happens when I parallel connect them? I have a Victron 150 MPPT. Well, Jan, the big benefit of having solar panels connected in serial is that you have a higher open clamp voltage. That means that the regulator starts earlier charging your battery, and also this lasts longer in the day. So over the day, you harvest more energy. On parallel, of course, you have a higher current also, which means also, not in your case, but if you have a big system, then also your wiring should be thicker. So the advice overall is use panels in series as much as possible, because that only has benefits for you. Sometimes you get the remark, well, if you have parallel and one is shaded, you still have a lot of power. Well, that also goes for serial connected panels, because serial connected panels having bypass diodes, that means if one is in the shade, still the other one will supply energy to your battery. Next question. The next question is coming from Alex, and Alex says, can anybody help me size the cable size for an Orion Smart 1212 30 amps DC-DC converter? Well, basically, Alex, the incoming power is approximately the same as the outgoing power, because you have a 12 to 12 volt converter. That means the cable size on the input is the same as the cable size on the output. If you want to know which cable size you need, we have a very nice app, the Victron Toolbox, and there you can do a calculation on which size cable you need for which amps. The next question is coming from Martin, and Martin is asking, can this Cerbo GX connected over VE.Bus port on the MultiPlus adjust all the settings like battery, charger, chemistry, type, charge amps, and so on? Well, Martin, yes and no. Basically, the Cerbo can be connected to the internet. So by using VE Configure remotely through the VRAM portal, you can load a new configuration file into your Multi. You cannot configure the Multi directly. It's only done through the remote portal. But when you're there, it's often much easier to have the computer directly connected to your device and make the settings there. But if needed, you can also do it remotely. Thanks for watching. This was the last question. If you have some questions on your own, please leave a comment, and I'll see you next episode. Bye.